In order to get an answer on a very important question, how TTIP might affect the employment and income situation of people in Germany, we also calculated how such an agreement would affect different and various skill groups.
According to our calculations, a total of about 160,000 new jobs would be created as a result of TTIP, just from the increasing trade between Germany and the US. However, this does not take into account other trade diversion effects, such as those within Europe. Approximately 75,000 of these new jobs would be in the service sector and in branches of industry that do not directly export. And there would be 85,000 newly created jobs directly in the manufacturing industry. These jobs are the ones that we want to look at more closely. If we assume that the new jobs in these sectors are evenly distributed throughout the states of the Federal Republic, then the following picture would emerge. Going on this assumption, a treaty would result in new manufacturing industry jobs in every state. As can be seen, most of the jobs would be created in states with high export figures such as Bavaria, Baden-Württemberg, and North Rhine-Westphalia. Not surprisingly, the main industries located in these states are ones that would particularly benefit from declining trade costs: the electronics industry, metal production and metalworking, and vehicle and machine construction, for example. But what kind of jobs would be created in specific terms? In order to answer this question, we looked at how the increases in employment in the branches of the manufacturing industry would affect highly skilled, average skilled, and low skilled individuals. The first thing our calculations show here is that additional jobs would be created for all skill levels. In other words, also for low-skilled workers who have not completed secondary school or a vocational training program. It is expected that most of the new jobs for low-skilled workers will be created in the metal production and metalworking industry, in the electronics sector, and in the chemical industry, a sector that shows a comparably large proportion of low-skilled individuals. By contrast, new jobs for highly skilled persons would be expected primarily in machine and vehicle construction, in addition to the electrical industry. But how will a free trade agreement affect the pocketbook, in other words, the income of these skill groups? First, we can show that real income would increase in all skill groups. Interestingly, our calculations show in this regard that the increased income effect from increased bilateral trade will be more pronounced for low-skilled individuals than for average or highly skilled workers. Accordingly, we expect about 0.9% increase in real wages for low-skilled individuals. By contrast, the real wages of average and highly skilled individuals will increase by 0.7% and 0.6% respectively.
So much on the effects of different skill groups. If you want to know more on sectoral effects of such an agreement, please have a look at our other GED Insights.